Hello, welcome to Dimensionality Reduction using Feature Extraction and Feature Selection. Dimensionality reduction is the process of reducing the number of variables or features in review. Dimensionality reduction can be divided into two subcategories called feature selection, which includes wrappers, filters, and embedded, and feature extraction, which includes principal components analysis. So how exactly does dimensionality reduction improve performance? It does so by reducing the number of features that are to be considered. To see how this works, think of a simple algebraic equation, A plus B plus C plus D equals E. If you can equate AB equals A plus B, making a representation of two variables into one, then you're using feature extraction to reduce the number of variables. Now, consider if C was equal to zero, or an arbitrarily small number. It wouldn't really be relevant, therefore it could be taken out of the equation. By doing so, you'd be using feature selection, because you'd be selecting only the relevant variables and leaving out the irrelevant ones. Feature selection is the process of selecting a subset of relevant features or variables. There are three main subset types: wrappers, filters, and embedded. To help you visualize how feature selection works, imagine a set of variables. Let's use a series of shapes, for example, with each shape representing different dimensions or features. By ignoring the irrelevant variables, or selecting the ones that improve accuracy, we reduce the amount of strain on the system and produce better results. Wrappers use a predictive model that scores feature subsets based on the error rate of the model. While they're computationally intensive, they usually produce the best selection of features. A popular technique is called stepwise regression. It's an algorithm that adds the best feature or deletes the worst feature at each iteration. Filters use a proxy measure which is less computationally intensive but slightly less accurate. So it might have a good prediction, but it still may not be the best. Filters do capture the practicality of the dataset, but in comparison to error measurement, the feature set that's selected will be more general than if a wrapper was used. An interesting fact about filters is that they produce a feature set that don't contain assumptions based on the predictive model, making it a useful tool for exposing relationships between features, such as which variables are bad together and as a result drop the accuracy, or good together and therefore raise the accuracy. Embedded algorithms learn about which features best contribute to an accurate model during the model building process. The most common type is called a regularization model. In our shape example, it would be similar to picking the shapes or good features in each step of the model building process. It might be picking the triangle feature in step 1, picking the cross feature in step 2, or picking the lightning feature in step 3 to obtain our accurate model. Feature extraction is the process of transforming or projecting a space composing of many dimensions into a space of fewer dimensions. This is similar to representing data in multiple dimensions to ones that are less. This is useful for when you need to keep your information but want to reduce the resources that it may consume during processing. The main linear technique is called principal components analysis. There are other linear and non-linear techniques, but reviewing them here is out of scope for this course. Principal components analysis is the reduction of higher vector spaces to lower orders through projection. It can be used to visualize the dataset through compact representation and compression of dimensions. An easy representation of this would be the projection of a three-dimensional plane to a two-dimensional one. A plane is first found which captures most, if not all, of the information. Then the data is projected onto new axes and a reduction in dimensions occurs. When the projection of components happens, new axes are created to describe the relationship. This is called the principal axes, and the new data is called principal components. This becomes a more compact visualization for the data, and thus is easier to work with. Thanks for watching.